Mark, your thoughts on that one?
Listen, I thought we played particularly well. First 5 minutes, 10 minutes, we weren't at it. And after we scored the goals, I think we were pretty comfortable. You know, we controlled possession, a lot of nice football out there for the boys. The only disappointing thing is we couldn't convert our chances when we were on top in the game. I mean, clear-cut chances in the second half could have put the game really to bed. And we invited a wee bit of pressure on ourselves, but I thought we were strong enough to see it out. Obviously, a couple of penalty decisions were disappointing. But we've seen it out, and that's really my only grumble, that we didn't score more today.
Yeah, was it nervier at the end than it should have been?
Well, it should have been when you're 3-0 up. You know, you should be cruising and enjoying the game. And we were still doing things right. But obviously, when it goes 3-2 and you're into the last 10 minutes, then it's always going to become a wee bit nervy. But still, I thought we were comfortable enough. We had another two or three chances at the end that could have wrapped up before we did score. So, kind of complain with how the boys played. You know, been working on things through the week and pressing and controlling possession, and I thought they took that into the game today.
Ryan and Russell up front look a real handful.
Yeah, they are, I mean, experienced players. I mean, Andy Ryan's only 22, but it looks like he's been about for years the way he plays the game. And Russell obviously knows how to play the game. He's a clever player, played at a good level. And they give us so much up front in terms of goals and movement, but the guys behind them do an equally important job as well. Our midfield guys and our back four together today all came together nicely. And you know, you always like to keep clean sheets, but I suppose that's me just being picky. I thought they were terrific today.
And what's the secret of this management? I mean, it seems you come in, you won 6 on the trot. They've been on a great run.
It's been a great run, yeah. There's no secret to it. The players perform. It's not me. I know loads of managers say that. We put on training, we put ideas in their heads of how certain teams are going to play and how we want to play. It's up to them to go over the white line and do it for themselves. And you can see how much they work for each other. You know, it's a close-knit squad. They all get on well with each other. I think that comes across in the pitch. So I hope that continues. And, you know, we'll keep working on the training pitch, because although we've been in a good run, there's definitely still improvements to be made. And it'll be tough, and it'll take a wee while to get our style across, but we'll get there in the end. But as long as we keep churning out victories like this, we should be okay.
Livingston and Alloa, the teams demoted from the Championship last season, they're probably the favourites to go up this term. Do you think you've got in you to sort of sustain a challenge up at the top?
Yeah, totally. I mean, you're right, they are favourites, and rightly so. Biggest budgets, they've come down. And people were talking about them early on in the season, and they went on great runs and they won games, and we've just slowly edged our way up the league without much fuss being made of us. And we quite like that, you know. We quite like just being in the background and picking up points here and there, and that suits us. But the boys get belief, more belief everyone they achieve, and it's important to keep momentum going. Disappointed that we lost last week in the cup, but it shows that we got that out of our system, and we went about it the right way today.
Well done, thanks Mark. Right.